Welcome to Savvy IT Solutions. In the previous video, we learned about forms in HTML. So now we are trying to learn the how to create forms practically using Sublime Text 3. So generally, we need to save this file. So named as form.html. So now we are trying to write. So here form, here we are implementing it. So the first one is which one? Form. The tag is form and the name is form1. So before going to this, I will write in the better. Yeah, so it creates this. So name is equal to form1, id is equal to form1, and action, here we need to write either file.jsp or file.asp or file.php. So in the latter section we are learning about php, so I am writing next.php. Now I am not implementing any code related to next.php, just we are handling how the form is. So one more method is left, that is method attribute, either post or get. So after that, what we need to write? We need to create a form. Just we need to use all the things what are available in the form. So try to make it. So input, the type is equal to text and the name is equal to full name. Okay, so here in the video we are not at all discussing more things, but by defaultly we are using HTML5, so I am also introducing few more things, that is placeholder. So the placeholder is, we need to mention full name, and required is one option, that is mandatory. Okay, required so actually required we need to write directly, but not mentioned, so leave it. So next one is we are placing the name. Now we need to make email ID, so the tag is email and name is email ID. Similarly, placeholder xyz at the rate of abc.com. We are giving the examples. So instead of including ID, we are also name, we are also giving ID as same. So apart from these, we are reading the text, we are reading the email, we are reading a phone number. So number, directly we can use phone. Phone is also an attribute in HTML5. Directly we can use mobile, ID is equal to mobile, placeholder so 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, right. So here we need to take gender. So when we are going for gender, we need to use input type is equal to chick. The name is gender. Value male. Okay. Slash br. Again, we need to take input type chick, name gender, value female. Female. So after saving this, we need to view the output how it looks. So then we will go and implement according to our requirements. So it opens. So right. So checkbox is not updated. Not check. It is checkbox. So it's giving clarity. So full name. So I think it is not in a sequential way. But how we need to convert this in a sequential way, we will tell you later. First of all, we are using all the things in a single row. So here I need to remove br and view it all are in sequence. So okay, these are the check boxes and the name is gender. At the same time, I am also giving ID is gender, and I think radio is the right keyword. Yes, anyone will be checked, right? Good, fine. So now we are going to use checkbox, okay? Checkbox with courses you offered, courses you choose. So input type, the type is checkbox, and name is course, value is programming in C, programming in C, and again we need to use input type checkbox. Okay, sorry, the course is course 1, we put it course 1, course 2, value is programming in Java. Input checkbox, name is course 3, value technologies, now I saved it. And I need to view, so here we need to check multiple options. Fine. Now I will also use drop down box and text area in the next one. So select name is equal to what we need to give country. So option value is 1, and option 2 value is 2. Again option value 3 UK. So let them see how it reflects. Okay, so meanwhile what I am doing is one more option is used, that is value is null, select the country. So now it changes systematically. So all are in single line. Now we can change this into a beautiful way. First, generally we need to do it. After that, we will apply some button. So finally, we are also using one button for that. Conclude with a button. But name. Submit ID, submit and value submit. So automatically the button also visible extra. Now we are in, we create in a better way, means look and feel will be created. So the first one is name. Fill name. So after this we need to put BR. So again here also email ID. After email ID we will put break. So the next one is phone number. After phone number we will put break. Now we can see a little bit changes are occurred. Full name. So here it gives some look and feel of the application. So that is what exactly it need. Okay. So the next one is gender. After that we need to put, so here we need to select the course. Select courses. So that's the title is perfect. So now when it closes means here it will be break. Finally country. when I'm refreshing it, when compared to previous one, this form will gives a look and feel very clearly. So what clearly we understand is designing is the more when we are designing a form, we need to take more clarity regarding this. Okay, so this is the way we are designing it. So I think you understand very clearly how we are designing a form. So in the next video, what we need to cover is we need to create three forms. So one is the registration form, second one is login form, and third one is forget password form. And we need to link these three forms, and we need to navigate from one page to another page very clearly. That is what we are taking into object. So I think you understand very clearly how we are using all the things. Okay, in the next video also we are adding tables concept to give a better look and feel of all the things. Thank you.